Well, good afternoon. I'm making the presentation of a study that has been carried out by our student under the supervision of my colleague Juan Campos, that will speak after me, other components of my team, which is centered in the characterization of and mapping of biological activity related with the affection of land by mining activity in South and Central Spain. The studied area corresponds to what is called the San Quintín mining area, which is located in the south of the province of Ciudad Real, in south of Madrid, some 300 kilometers away from Madrid, and corresponding to the commissioning abandoned the exploitation of lead, silver, plus zinc and other heavy metals exploded between 1960 and 1919, and located some 50 kilometers away from my working place, the Almaden School of Mines, which is based on the main mercury mining district in the world. The area was abandoned with no reclamation or restoration activities, and is like that since 1990. And well, this is the satellite image of the mining area, separated in two sub-areas, San Quintín West and San Quintín East, and we are going to focus in the San Quintín East area. It is not too big, around one kilometer in diameter, but affected by intense change of the soil use. This corresponds to the delimitation of areas with different degrees of affection by mining, and includes the area we have studied, the original soil from the surrounding areas, the polluted soil, which are areas in which the soil has received some input from mining products, but still the soil is the original soil. Anthrosols, which are areas that have been excavated or which has suffered the presence of gangue piles, which are in part dismantled. Also, these are the anthrosols, the tailing dams, the mining products after the passage by the concentration process, the tailings from the washing process are accumulated in these dams. Also the gangue piles in yellow, and well, it's also the area was also affected by the presence of organic waste leakage, consisting in material and residua from olive oil processing. This area, with some patches that still correspond to that material, and the rest, it happened in the 1995 or something like that, and then in part this organic waste has been washed, but in part they remain there as patches or mixed with the anthrosols of this area. Well, of course, we all know mining produces important degradation of the local soils due both to compactation, the load of the gangue piles like this, but with maybe as in the first photograph, maybe with 10 meters high, produce they correspond to loads of 1,000 tons, and they of course produce the compactation of the soil and the chemical processing, the weather processing of the sulfide, the metallic sulfide, produce the release and the infiltration of pollutants, including heavy metals such as lead, zinc, copper, arsenic, even mercury coming from Armaden. And well, the result is a loss of the losses are an area like this, with of course loss of any, of almost any biological activity. Professor Campos is going to show us that how this is regenerating after all this time, and of course a complete loss of agriculture productivity. Well, the biological activity in the soil is a most important biological indicator directly related with microbiological activity in the soil, easy to measure and quantify. And then the objectives of this study has been the characterization and mapping of physicochemical parameters and enzymatic activity in these soils of this area. We have differentiating between the reference soils, the soils of the neighboring areas with low presence of mining activity, of mining products, and the soil clearly affected by the mining activity. We have measured physicochemical parameters of the soil and enzymatic activity, including four enzymes: dehydrogenase, beta-galactosidase, acid and alkaline phosphomonesterase, and ureas. The final aim, the final objective is to assess the impact of mining effect on the biological activity and soil quality of these soils clearly affected by the presence by the mining effect. And so, we took, for this preliminary study, we took 13 samples covering the different, the main different type of substrate, including the original soils, the polluted soils, the anthrosols, the tailing dams, and one sample from the organic waste. Sampling include drying, homogenization, and then analysis of physicochemical parameters, and then sample preservation and analysis of the enzymatic activity, following standardized protocols for reactivity, for electric conductivity, and instrumental analysis, spectrophotometric analysis of the enzymatic activity, also following published protocols. And then the results shows soil reactivity, which is acid in the samples analyzed, with of course the maximum acidity on the regolite, but also in the organic waste. Of course, this is due to the presence of, or the formation of, the acidity typical of mining, weathering of mine of sulfide products, but also very low pH in the organic waste coming from oil processing industry. The main process producing the acidity in the regolite is the pyrite oxidation, which produce the release of acidity, which is the responsible for the change in pH in the soil, the reactivity in the soil. Of course, this process also produces the release of salts, mainly sulfates, and show the soil conductivity, the soil electric conductivity as a criteria for containing in of soils in the sand, salts in the soil. Also shows that the original the soil mining soils has in general much higher than original soils electric conductivity, and so a much higher salt content as expected. Concerning the organic matter content, of course, these are soils coming from a semi-arid area with low to very low organic matter content, and only the sample taken from the organic waste reach high contents in organic matter. The hydrogenase activity is very clear, the difference between the original soil and all the mining soils values of activity which are clearly higher than the activity in the rest of the soils, except for the organic waste and except for the regolith, that in which we could have also a mixture, a partial mixture with this organic waste. Beta galactosidase activity finds also different levels in the different in the different products or different soils, very low in original soils and polluted soils, and higher in regolith tailings and organic waste. We are not sure about the significance of these, but it's one of our objectives to try to find out what produced that important activity of beta-galactosidase activity, which is very important in the biological cycling of carbon. But we still need to investigate this. With the phosphomonasterase activity, is it an alkaline? Variations are not so significant, except for the high values in the organic waste. And what is important, what is the only question to notice is the higher activity of the acid phosphomonasterase due to the acid character of the local soils produced by the organic,
Pablo, just 3 minutes left.
Yeah. Urea's activity is more regular in general terms. The differences are not even in between samples from the same soils, the variability is very high. So up to date, we don't have good criteria to know why we have so important variability of ureasa, which is important in the biological biochemical cycling of nitrogen. Finally, concerning the relationship between the different parameters, we see that there is a relationship, not a very proximal relationship between reactivity and salt contents. The only clear relationship, or the only close relationship, is between the organic matter and the phosphomonasterase. That relationship between the hydrogenase activity and urease, and beta-galactosidase, which doesn't seem to have clear relationship with the rest of any of the rest of parameters. So our conclusions is that the hydrogenase activity has proven to be the best indicator for the microbiological activity of the soils affected by mining activity. It's a good discriminant of the different type of soils that we have sampled. And then still on due course, the relationship with other with the heavy metal content in the soil that we have analyzed, but we don't have the would probably provide better insights into the local distribution of the rest of the enzymatic activity. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Pablo. Another fascinating talk, and also on time. Thank you for that. Last time, I said this time for one quick question, and I got a full-blown debate. We really just have time for one quick question this time.
Thank you very much. It's very interesting. A very naive question. Mm-hmm. Based on your results, can you actually suggest or recommend a restoration plan according to what you found? Can you suggest a restoration? I mean, basically, I guess everyone would like this area to be natural again, right? I guess that's one of the goals of everyone who works on this type of project. Is that a good... So, I'm just trying, based on your results, okay, can you think of a restoration? Can you come up with a restoration plan in order to restore the area?
Yeah, of course. Well, this is a situation which is very common in our region. Lead zinc mining is widespread in all the area, and of course all these location needs a restoration based on, of course, with of something that needs a lot of money, and of course it wasn't carried out in the when the mining activity closed, and then nowadays it's difficult to it needs a reprocessing, well, covering of the area with, but it's expensive, it's not easy because probably the only the only clear possibility is to avoid what I haven't talked about the but it is also an important question in this, which is the release of acid mine drainage. So the acid mine drainage is affecting areas and affecting to the rivers in the area, but the neutralization of that water and the avoiding the release of the heavy metal contents. But the area is complicated to make a good restoration plan for that should be to cover, to seal all the area. In Almaden, with the mercury, the big mercury mine, they carried out a restoration plan, an important, but the mining company was active, but nowadays this mining company disappeared, and
it's complicated. The question is, it's reversible or irreversible process?
Sorry?
It's reversible or irreversible process? This is the question.
Yeah, well,
it's the most important.
Because if you're natural, you can let it.
Yeah, well,
this is the question.
It's complicated.
It's irreversible.
Okay, this is bad.
That's the point. We must help it to recover. we can do things, and it's based on the microbiology.
You know, the last time the scientist spoke with a dead person, but he never answered. This is
not
a problem.
It's not a person.
Yeah, this is a problem.
It's the microbiome.
Irreversibility is.
The only thing that is happening is that people are going to take the aggregates which is from the Gange pipes, which are not Gange, has also a lot of ore, and they take it to make roads or tracks, yeah. And then they pollute the surrounding areas, and then.
Pablo, we do have 30 seconds left. It's like being on a live radio program sitting here. So I'll ask you a very quick question. How do you distinguish between soil and the regolith?
Sorry, man?
What's the distinction between soil and the regolith? On one of your slides, you have soil and...
The regolith.
Regolith?
Yeah.
You wonder for the light. It's very clear. In the photos, it's easy to see that in the soil. Juan Antonio is now showing the difference of vegetation, and this sampling, this study has been the preliminary study to see which are the main environmental indicators for Portland, and try to find if they are clearly related with the distribution of the material. So still we need to make that more precise.
Okay, we better not preempt his talk. I'd like to thank Pablo once again. Thank you.
Thank you.